The Excel ribbon is the main location of most Excel commands. You can see the Excel ribbon here on your screen. The Excel ribbon has tabs labeled as follows: File, Home, Insert,
Page Layout, Formulas,
Data, Review, View, and sometimes Developer, depending on whether or not it is showing. Inside these tabs are Excel commands that are separated into different groups. Commands on the ribbon. A command is something that tells Excel what to do. An example of a command would be the fill color command, as shown here. Dialog boxes. As mentioned, there are groups of commands on every ribbon offered by each individual tab. On the bottom right corner of some command groups, you will see a small arrow button pointing down right. This arrow appears in command groups that provide more command options than can fit into the command group. By clicking this button, a dialog box will appear offering more options. For example, if you click on Insert tab, you will see the arrow button in the Charts group. If you click on the right arrow button, the Insert Charts dialog box will appear, offering you a large variety of chart options. Commands with contextual tabs. Some commands, such as charts, board art, and equations, have contextual tabs. Contextual tabs offer options directly related to the command you are using. For example, if you click on the equation command listed in the Insert tab, two contextual tabs named Drawing Tools and Equation Tools will appear. Types of buttons on the ribbon. Simple buttons. Simple buttons perform their command with one simple click. Examples of simple buttons are the Grow Font command button or Shrink Font command button, which both perform exactly what they say they will do with one simple click. Toggle buttons. A toggle button performs its task when clicked, but also displays information to let you know if it is already used or not already used. An example of a toggle button would be the italics command button in the font group. If a word is already italicized, then the italics button will appear orange to let you know that it has been used. A word is either italicized or it isn't. If a word is not italicized, then it will be if the cell is activated and the italics button is clicked. If a word is already italicized, then by clicking the italics button, the word will simply no longer be italicized. Simple dropdowns. Any command that has an arrow pointing down is a simple dropdown. Simple dropdowns give you several different options for the command. An example of a simple dropdown would be the font size. By clicking the down arrow, a box and scroll bar will appear that offers you many different sizes to make your fonts. Other examples are the font face command, number format, and any other buttons that have a drop-down menu. Split buttons. A split button control is a combination of a button that performs its command with one click, similar to a simple click button or a toggle button, and a drop-down command. You can simply click the button, perform a command, or click the arrow, which will offer you several different similar options. An example of a split button would be the Merge and Center button. If you were to highlight some cells and click this button, it would simply merge and center the cells with one click. You could also click the down arrow and it would give you other similar options such as Merge Across, Unmerge Cells, and more. Checkboxes. Checkboxes simply turn something on or off. An example of a checkbox command can be found under grid lines or headings. By checking the view box under grid lines, you would be able to see the grid lines, and if you unchecked it, you would not be able to see the grid lines in your worksheet. Spinners. Excel has one command that has a spinner button. This is the scale command, listed under the Scale to Fit group and the Page Layout tab. You can either scroll up or scroll down, which will increase or decrease the value.